I want to do something called Please Explain with Arnold Schwarzenegger, and it's based around your amazing Instagram page. It's amazing. Could you please explain to me, for example, how this happened?
This is amazing.
How did that happen? What possessed you to do that day?
Well, you just stand there like that and have a good time.
And everyone comes up to you.
That's right.
And it was just a regular Monday morning,
it was not a Monday morning, it was actually a Monday night. It just is very lit up because a lot of people were taking flash pictures. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You just decided to do that.
Exactly, yeah.
I've also got to ask you about your horse, Whiskey. Please tell
Whiskey,
me.
Whiskey. Whiskey is a pony, a miniature pony that lives out there in a stable, but feels much more comfortable coming into the house and eating regular human food. So I have to take him to the refrigerator every morning, and then I feed him out of the refrigerator so he feels like he's a human being. And then when I eat my oatmeal, he steals my oatmeal. When I look away, he kind of like goes right in there and starts eating my oatmeal. And but very, very funny, and he plays really well with my dog also, so they're kind of buddies. But awesome. He hangs out most of the time in the house.
Amazing.
Yeah.
See, this is why you on Instagram is better than most people. This is you carrying a cardboard cutout of yourself.
Yes, you have to do that sometimes, you know. If you see that you're maybe hanging out too long in an area, you just have to pick myself up and just carry myself out. And, you know, this is kind of like the Arnold of the day is schlepping around, you know, the Arnold of yesterday.
Okay.
Makes a funny photo.
Oh, it's amazing. Speaking of funny photos, this is you with a kangaroo.
Yeah, exactly. Well, what happens is that we have a lot of animals at the house. and so when we have parties, we call this agency that, you know, kind of takes care of animals. This is an animal shelter of rescued animals. And this is one of them. And so in order for them to make money and to keep those animals alive and to pay for it, for the food and everything, for the upkeep, they go to parties. And so they bring elephants, they bring tigers, they bring kangaroos, they bring alligators. I have every animal that you can think of when I have, for instance, a Christmas party or a poker tournament where we raise money, millions of dollars for after school programs and stuff like that. So I have all those animals over at the house.
Such as this one.
It's an elephant. You know, I'm a Republican, but the elephant is the symbol of the Republican Party. So there's a little dual kind of a spin there. But on top of that, it's also great when people arrive there at the party, they see the elephant there doing all his tricks, raising his legs or getting up an or two. And it's fun, and people just love animals. And it's one of the reasons why they come and play at the poker tournament is that they love to see the animals, and they also, you know, see another animal, me.
So. Did they ever come to see your impressive shoe collection, which I have here?
Oh, you do?
I love it.
Is it the shoe collection or the boot collection? That's the boot collection.
The boot collection.
See, I have the boots on right now. Mm-hmm. There you have it. This is one pair of the boots. But one of the important things is when you have exotic skins, which, you know, like ostrich or alligator, crocodile and all those things, you have to at least once a year put on, you know, nice lotion so that they don't crack. Mm-hmm. So you have them forever. And so this is what I do. Once a year, I bring all my boots down, I sit out in the sun, and then I go through it, and it takes me hours to put the cream on it, because you have to put on a layer of cream, then you set it aside, and then you have to go back again, and then you polish the shoes. And so I have like almost 50 pairs of cowboy boots, so there's a lot of work that needs to be done. But the key thing here is no one is allowed to touch them, because I want to do it myself. There's a lot of things like that I like to do myself, like washing my cars and stuff like that. A lot of things like this, it's total madness, but I mean, that's the way it is.
That's great.
Yeah.
This one's about a film, and I want to ask about how you got the smile right for Genesis. You do this kind of like, I'm trying to be with the humans, Terminator smile. How did you perfect that?
Yes, well, this is Terminator is very, very working very hard. He has been now since the 70s in America, and he has come from the future, sent back as the machine. But the key thing as a machine is to blend in so you don't get detected that you're a machine. And that's now here is an example where I try to convince someone, look, I'm kind of like, I'm a human being, look at this, and then they go like, you know, and do the smile. You know, of course, every time the Terminator tries to be human, he can't master it. Mm-hmm. He totally fails, and that's then what creates the humor in a movie.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Okay, this is my final one, and it's a vertical one. Tell me this is real.
It is real. As a matter of fact, this picture was taken in London at a gallery where they have oversized guns and oversized a lot of things. And so I thought, you know, since I was like Dirty Harry, when he pulled out this 357 Magnum and talks about it, I thought that it was a funny picture. The funny thing about it was is that after I posted that one, my daughter sent me one of herself with a gun, but not with this big one, but she took a regular one and just held it closer to the camera like this, and therefore it looked as big as this one. Was a very, very funny shot. But I mean, it's fun. And people enjoy those kind of shots.